Good morning. How are you doing today? Happy Diwali to all of you, first of all. I hope it was great. After COVID, this was first time when we did really celebrate this. So happy Diwali to all of you. In our earlier videos, we talked about backup, restoration, we talked about maintenance jobs, we talked about other aspects of restoration and what all things should be done in the backup and other things. So today we are going to talk about designing an index, how to do that, right? So let's start. Suppose there is a query which has been reported to you, or you have found out through a tool which is used in your organization for the monitoring, and you figured out that this is really very slow and it's doing millions of logical reads, or it's in hundreds of thousands and it's taking like maybe few seconds, or it could be in minutes, it could be in hours also, but now it's focused on something which is in minutes. Okay, or close to 50 or 45 seconds like that. So you have a query, you know the table structure, but you don't know the data. Okay, so you need to figure out what are the existing indexes. Are they really in use? If so, is it being used in this particular query? If yes, and if no. So in both the cases. So as of now, in this particular example, what we'll do is we'll have a query and we do not have any non-clustered index. What we have is only clustered index, okay? And it is basically joins on two tables with certain where clauses, okay? So I have prepared my lab and we would like to go into this. So see the query first and see how it is, right? So let's get into the lab. Okay, so this is the query that we are going to see, like how is the performance of that. Okay, so you can see the screen. We have aggregate function, and then it's joined on two tables, and then we have certain where clause. Okay, so either we can use this tool, or we can go to the default tool of Sybase ASC, which is this. Okay, so here now how to see the how much logical read it is doing, and how much second or how many millisecond is taking. So how to enable that? You can do set statistics IO and time on. This is the way we enable our reads in terms of pages, 8k pages here, because the page size is 8k in my particular lab. Okay, but it could be 2k, it could be 16k, it could be based on the thing that you have chosen while doing installation. Okay, we can also enable show plan on. Okay, so we can do like that, set show plan on, and this will show the exact plan of the query, how it has executed, right? So you can enable the trace in case you like it. It's not like very much required in all the cases. Okay, I mean, it's not required, it's fine. Okay, so this is the query. So let's copy this query and see how much time it takes and how many pages it does read. Okay, so see here. Sorry, I have to use the database name. Okay, now we can take this query and see the plan of this. Okay, so as you can see, it is doing 35,512 pages of logical read on test table A. Okay, now it could look like it's a very small number of pages, right? And in terms of time, it hardly took like 1 second, right? You can also see in the other tool, if you're using it here, it will complete in like 1 second. You can see 1928 to 29, so it's hardly a second. But if you see in terms of pages, it's 35,512 pages. So if you calculate it, 35,512 into 8, this will become like your KB. divided by 1024. Okay, so almost 277 megabyte of data it is reading from the disk and it's bringing to the cache. Okay, now is there any way we can improve the performance of this? Okay, so in this, as you can see, the most of the logical reads are happening on table 30, on the table test table A. So our main focus has to be on test table A. Now, with the query, because this is not something generic, we are not doing anything on the table level. What we are doing is on the query level. So in this case, what we have to do, we have to go through each of the conditions which is used either for join or on the where clause. So we have to go together and then we have to see which is the point which should be part of key of the index, and then which should be the first, what should be the second, what should be third, like that. Now to do that, there are two ways. First way is to find the count of that, right? And second way is to use the where clause. So if you see here, I prepared something. So this is the one which you can use for the count. Okay, then we can also specify the where clause. So either you go with this or you go with the count. Now in terms of count, if you go with the count, then if you are not sure about data, it could run in it could be in thousands, hundreds of thousands, or it could be even millions. So it will take more time for you to understand. So what I would like to do in this particular case is I will go with the where clause. And if you look at the query here, the query, if you see, this is type, status and all that, branch, you know, currency. So based on our common understanding, we can see the either it could be this particular column or the other column, which could be unique. But we are not sure about the data. So what we'll do is we'll try to figure out with this particular one. This is the one which I am taking from the query. Okay, so now what we'll do, we'll paste this here and we'll take the query and we'll see. Oh, it is like so many. Okay, so it's not something we can rely on. You can see 1271 rows are there. If we want, we can disable the statistics and time for now for us to understand the number of rows which is coming. Sorry, say statistics time IO off. Okay, and we can also disable the show plan as of now. Okay, so now if you copy the query again and if you run it here. Okay, so 1271 rows. We can also use the same thing here and we can run and see how it is, right? Okay, now we'll go in the second one and we'll see what is there. So this is first column that we have taken. Okay, now second one, how we'll see. I'm kind of aware that this is the column which should be unique in this particular table. Okay, but we have to go with each of them to find out. We can also see, for example, this particular number, how unique it is, right? So even that we can find out. I'm just trying to give you a basic brief idea how to find out what should be the columns in the indexes. Okay, this particular case, this will be the only index that we are going to create. So if we go with this, see, for instance, this is for the second column. Okay, so we can run that here and we can see, are we really getting 10,000 rows or we are not getting, because I have put like top 10,000 rows, right? It's already crossed 4,000, so I expect this to be close to 10,000. So if it is peaking at 10,000, means there are more number of rows, or at least 10,000 rows are there. So you can see 10,000, which means it is very much more than that, or at least 10,000, which is not very selective. Okay, now how about the status, CLR and other things? Okay, so let's copy that and see here. Oh, it is Okay, it's again 1000. So even if I change this to 5000, I guess I will get 5000 rows. Okay, so as you can see, it is going 5000. So that means it's much more than 5000. The number of rows are much more than 5000. Okay, so I ran multiple queries to figure out what should be the actual thing. And if you see here, this query, if you run it, this gives me only 30. This set of combination of column seems to be very unique. Okay, now let's see if there is something more which can be used. I guess there is nothing more. So here we have already seen with the status CLR column, this goes more than 1000 or like 5000. So this cannot be the one. So this is the one which seems to be unique. So I think we have run this query and we have seen how many results are there earlier. Okay, so if at all we create an index on these two columns, transaction if, okay, identifier number it seems to be, and status CLR, this is supposed to help us. Okay, so now what we'll do is we'll create this index, but before creating this index, I want to show you something very important here. Okay, so let me enable the plan and time again. Okay, and set show plan on. We did not go through the plan in this particular video, but we'll just try to see in this case. Okay, okay, so this is our query. Now see, okay, here in the plan you can see test table A, it is doing it is looking for the primary key clustered index, you can see here. Okay, now 64 kilobytes for data pages and all. Now let's see other thing. For test table B, what it is doing, it is again reading the clustered index here, right? And let me show you the other one. There is a work table one here. Okay, work table one is basically the table which is created for performing join on these two tables. So this is something which has spilled data into TempDB. So with the right set of column in the index, you can avoid this also. We'll see that. So here what we'll do, we'll create this index on this table. We'll name it, this is IX underscore test table A, and these two columns. Okay, so let's create this. And then we'll run the same query and we'll see. Earlier you saw it was 35,512 logical reads. Okay, let's keep it somewhere. So this will be used for our records. Okay, so let's comment out. This could take a while because this table is a little, you can say, big in size. So these all things you need to perform a test environment or UAT environment to really, you can say R&D, or you can say you have to try multiple times and see which one is really suitable. Okay, there are possibility you can have index. You won't be able to find the leading column. However, it will take more time for you to find other columns in the index. Okay, as a thumb rule, you need to have 5 columns in an index and 5 index on a table. But then this is not something which is very much specific. It depends on case to case. Okay, so our index has been created now. So let's go ahead and use the same query again and see how many logical read we are doing now. Okay, so see, 33, isn't it great? From 35,312 to 33, this is really great. But then let's just check the plan. I'm sure it is using our index. You can see our index is being used here. And then now you see we still have work table one. Okay, it's not much in terms of logical reads. Okay, you can see only 4. However, if we could avoid that, Okay, this would really help. In this particular case, test table B seems to be very less because you can see number of pages it's doing from the B is very like 2 pages only. So it's very small table for the condition that we have. However, for other table, when we have like larger table, so in that case, join becomes very important, right? So what we would like to do is we'll drop this index now and we'll try with something else, okay? In the meantime, we'll drop this index. Test table A, table name dot index name. Okay, this is very fast. Now create this index which will be used for our join. Okay. So here you can see status CLR transaction type A. So transaction type A is the one which is used for the join. This comp code, I think it's not something which is very important in this particular case for these two tables join. Okay. So as I said, this table is big in size and now we have one more column. So it will take longer than it took like previously. Okay, so just wait for this to complete. And in the meantime, you can see what all things we have taken. Status P we did not take because this is not something very, this will not something which will narrow down the size of the result. Okay, so index creation is done. Now what we'll do, we'll take the same query and we'll see. In the meantime, let's see how many read it had done in the past. It was 33, right? Okay. So let's paste that one and see how it is. And you see, 33 remained 33. However, if you see, the work table 1 has disappeared, right? So work table 1 has disappeared, which means here we do not have anything which has spilled to disk. It has not gone to tempdb, right? So in this case, and now you can see here the plan of this, it has used our index. Okay, so this is one example wherein we have reduced the number of pages from 33,512 to 33, right? Now, is it enough? Depends. We can even reduce it further, but then your index will become bigger and bigger. It will contain more number of columns. Okay, so is it really required? 33 is very good. In terms of time also, if you see how much time is taking right now, you can see it's 0 millisecond. Before it was taking 1 second, 1112 millisecond it was taking. Now it's 0 millisecond. CPU time and retrieve server time, both ASC time and this time, both of them are 0. Before it was 1112 second. Okay, so this is something which I showed you. This is just an example like how to design the index. Now this again varies based on the query. This varies based on the size. This varies based on the selectivity of column. Lot many things. Okay, it's not something which you can decide straight away or which you can find out without really checking the data quality of it. Okay. So I hope this will help you in designing the index on Sybase ASE. Here we also talked about how to enable the plan, how to see the plan. And we also enable the statistics in terms of time, in terms of logical read, which is IU. Okay, how to enable and we have set statistics time IO on and we have set show plan on. So this will help also in finding out how to do that. In the tools, it's very straightforward. However, for the on the IS skill, on the command based, you need to write these commands. Okay, so I hope this will be helpful for you in designing the index, and this will also help in finding the right column in the right order. Okay, first column is very important as we had discussed earlier. So in this, the transaction if was very important. Okay, because that is one which is very, very selective. Okay, so that would be pretty much of it today. I hope you liked it. If you like, please comment and subscribe my channel. Okay, we'll have more and more videos coming in next few days. Okay, so thank you very much for watching. Have a great day. Thank you. Bye.